Hi everyone, I'm Mike.
Wow, you don't gotta sound so depressed.
Hi everyone, I'm Mike!
No, that was too loud.
You fucking asshole!
And I guess we're here to... Well, to explain what this video is gonna be, is I have a list that has no order whatsoever about a bunch of E3 games that we're just gonna share our thoughts on.
This is the E3 talk.
Yeah, pretty much.
With four guys on a couch.
You ever wanted a really unorganized talk about E3?
It's here, right here.
So we're going to start at the top of the list for some reason is God of War.
Jesus, yeah. I changed my pants after I saw that trailer.
That was pretty awesome.
In gameplay.
I loved the reaction as soon as Kratos stepped out.
Dude, everyone was fucking roaring, man. I mean, Kratos is loved by all PlayStation. That's what I said.
Exactly, I'm just saying it's Kratos.
Yeah, it's loved by all PlayStation players.
Yeah.
You scrubs.
And,
I own a PlayStation, and I play it, so I'm just joking, but...
Oh, boy.
Anyways, amazing looking game.
Yes, it looks pretty awesome.
Gameplay 100% has changed since all the other God of War.
Yes, because this one's more in third person.
It says it kind of keeps some of the fighting style.
Yeah.
But what I was talking to Mike before when you were gone earlier is that it looks not so much as just hack and slash button mashing like the originals were, but this kind of has, kind of looks Dark Souls-y, how you actually have to dodge, unlike in the first ones. You could just smash the buttons and no one's going to care. You're going to kill them eventually.
You can dodge from the other guy.
But, I mean, this, when he fights the troll in the gameplay, it just, like, seems like a boss battle in Dark Souls or something.
Except it easy. Does. I see where that's
at. Yeah, except easy. Except easy.
Yeah, Dark Souls will make you want to...
Moving on to the next in order, in our order, is Steep.
This I don't know too much
this,
about.
I am shockingly very excited to see. I used to love games like SS Tricky or SSX or whatever, those snowboarding games. And this is an open world game set on these mountaintops. Isn't it in the French Alps or something?
I think so. And pretty neat.
You can switch between four extreme sports, you know, share jumps, put out challenges to your friends or accept challenges from the community, try to do those jumps, just wander around, see people everywhere. It looks like an intense game.
Do some wingsuit and run into people in mountains.
What's cool is that you aren't like a normal snowboarding and skiing games. You're basically stuck to snowboarding and skiing. This you can wingsuit and what was the other thing?
Parachute, wingsuit.
It's paragliding. It's paragliding, wingsuit, skiing, and snowboarding.
I mean, you have a little bit more options, which is pretty cool. I mean, I personally would enjoy wing suiting in real life, but I'm too fat for that crap.
And during the gameplay presentation, they even showed someone crash into a mountainside.
Oh,
and
man.
And he, like, he just made a scream when he was like, oh!
Now, like, that over. Personally seems like a game that would be kind of interesting in VR.
Yeah, I could see that.
I could see that being very interesting.
Yeah, it would be a little, get Pepto-Bismol. Because you're going to be flying all over the place. And that's got to be a little...
Okay, maybe not for like the wingsuit, but nauseating. I mean snowboarding or skiing.
I would try it.
I would too.
But the game itself, I want to get it.
Yeah, definitely. When it comes out, I want to get it.
Me personally, I'm not super like...
Active?
No, but yes, I'm that also. Yeah, I need to get more active.
Well, I'm not one to do any of these sports in real life, so...
I would.
I mean... Me personally, I'm not too hyped for it. It looks like it's got very good potential, but who knows? You know, it could flop. It's got the potential to flop also.
Yeah, because
Ubisoft is publishing it, so you up there.
Okay. I think we're good for the next
Horizon
one.
Horizon Zero Dawn.
I want it. It
awesome.
Needs to be. Yep, fine.
It looks awesome.
They announced this last year at E3. CG trailer, incredible, right?
Yes.
Yes, looked awesome.
Gameplay this year, incredible.
Again,
visually
awesome.
Stunning. I like the dialogue systems actually in there with multiple options. It's not just the talk to the person. The quests seemed kind of interesting. She was on the taming of the robots.
I may have missed it. I want to know how that became. I want to know how the robots became. I'm sure we'll find out.
If you watch the, it's got a campaign trailer.
Yeah, there's a story trailer.
It kind of teases what happens because you play as you basically, the way they describe you is you come from nowhere. No one knows how you became to be. You don't even know exactly how you became to be, but you start learning it as you go on in your journey. So you're an outcast in this tribe, is what it's kind of. There's a dragon coming for me.
Speaking of robot revolutions, we're playing Overwatch.
Yeah.
So, which is unrelated to E3 at all.
Yeah, sorry.
It's not there.
But it's just
fun.
It looks awesome.
And yeah,
I definitely picked that shit up.
And a release date in February, correct?
Yes, and a release date. February, I think 28th is what it is. I could be wrong, but definitely February.
So, speaking of new games that look incredible, not the least in my opinion, Gears 4.
Old Marcus!
Welcome home, James.
Ah, just so hyped for that moment.
And Horde Mode, confirmed.
Horde Mode, 3.0 is what they claimed it as. Confirmed. Hyped for that, because Horde Mode is just... the best thing that's ever happened in Gears of War multiplayer.
I played the beta for Gears 4. And,
a video. Go watch it.
Yeah. Oh, it's in there somewhere. I was not too digging it, to be honest, because I don't like the multiplayer in Gears. But the storage mission they showed during E3 got me hyped for it.
Oh, dude, the story
looks pretty awesome.
I'm not going to confirm this, but the Swarm, I think they are definitely something to do with the Locust.
I mean, look at it.
They literally have the same name. There's drones, which are the name of the regular foot soldiers in original Gears. They have siege beasts, just like the Locust in original Gears.
Like that one that broke down the door?
Yeah, that's a siege beast.
Oh, and that new weapon they showed, too. The buzzkill?
Oh, the buzzkill.
That shot the buzzsaws that were
bouncing. Oh, yeah. The execution for that, he just picks someone up and shoots his head off with a saw blade. Intense. Whole game itself's intense. The beta, I liked it. I'm just throwing this in there. Because it was it kind of goes back to the Gears 1, which I enjoyed. It's kind of got the Gears 1 multiplayer, which was my favorite, if you ask me. I've loved all the Gears, so that's why I liked it.
Gears are pretty good. I've never been a huge fan of them, but I mean, I like them. They're fun.
Next game.
We started with all the best games for some reason. For Honor.
For Honor finally has a release date. That's the best part about this. February 14th, 2017.
The combat in the game itself for the story mission didn't look as intricate as it does in the multiplayer, though. And that's one grievance I had with it. But grievance is hard to say because you just showed me Vikings storming a samurai settlement, and as soon as I could get my erection to go down, I saw one thing that a little annoyed me.
What was that?
The combat seeming as intricate.
Like,
against the nameless minions.
Is that all you fight are minions? Is there any, like, in the multiplayer, there's five main people?
I'm pretty sure there were some main people.
I wasn't 100%
sure. I don't
sure.
remember.
You were wanting to use your sword against them.
Yeah.
It was a Viking, so it would have been that, most likely.
Okay.
Just curved with the team.
But it just... I've wanted the game since last year when they announced it. I was hoping it would come out last year. No. So I was hoping this year. No. But now that it's finally got a release date
and
confirmed.
It's early next year. It's in February as well. On Valentine's Day.
Oh, happy Valentine's Day.
Fuck the dates. I'm playing that.
Scalebound.
Another awesome looking game that they announced last year.
This game. And only one of us so far doesn't have an Xbox One. Vance, who isn't here for today's video, he's out and about, so we're here talking.
And but he's most hyped for this.
He's getting an Xbox One for Scalebound.
Yes. He is buying it for this game in particular. Nothing else.
And this game looks like so much fun with your friends. Y'all get up, you choose a class, you choose your dragon, and you go out and you hunt some bosses together. It's Monster Hunter on the Xbox. It's what it looks like to me.
That would be pretty awesome.
Yeah. It does have a story, though, I believe.
Yeah, and they showed that boss fight against that spider, which had multiple stages.
We have confirmed this while you were gone. It is a spider scorpion crab. That's what it is.
Yes.
Well, it had multiple stages in that boss fight, which were awesome.
Yes.
The fight kept changing.
You fought, you had to fight it in the air because it was too far away for your base, which is a bow and arrow, which is kind of weird. I'm going to get into that in a second, though. He was too far away, so you had to fly your dragon to actually fight it at first. And one thing I want to point out is the dragons are different. You can get different dragons, but your character was all the same person. Same style character. There wasn't any difference between them.
There except were a few the different weapons.
I mean, but it was the same short-haired...
And maybe that was just the same E3 costume. Demo?
Yeah, it could be just because it was an E3 demo.
Very, very possible.
Yes, but
did that have a release date? I think that just said 2017.
Yeah, I don't think it has an official release date yet. But hopefully it's soon.
I'm pumped for it, and I'm pumped to play that with multiple people.
Yeah,
because I think four of us agreed that we were going to get it. So,
Sticking on the Microsoft topic, Forza Horizon 3.
Never mind.
Oh, before I bring that up, before you say you again, Xbox, you're the fucking kings right now.
No.
You buy an exclusive on the Xbox One, you get a free copy on your computer,
sorry,
which you
can't
continue
beat
progress.
That. You can't,
no,
you
can't beat
that.
I'm a PlayStation guy, but that is pretty awesome.
That is a great feature.
That is an awesome feature. And the backwards compatibility, that's awesome too. That PlayStation really needs to...
You can buy some of your old games again.
Well, yeah, you can buy them, but I wish you could,
Yeah, I was going to say something, but I'm pretty sure it's later on our list, so I won't say it yet. But, yes, I mean, one thing I don't think we have on the list, so I'm going to throw in right now, is that Project Scorpio.
I do not have that on there.
It's not on our list because we didn't really, look it up. But... the fact that they're releasing that and you'll be able to play your Xbox One games on it and those Project Scorpio games on the Xbox One. That's also a plus.
What they did
Xbox
mention
got.
With the Xbox One S thing as well, that it's going to be the family of three Xbox Ones, and they said the games will be released on it to be playable
accessories
on all
and everything. That's another thing Xbox
they don't
has want
to leave anyone behind, so everyone's going to be able to play everything.
Now back to the official thing on the list here.
Oh, Horizon.
Horizon. Beautiful.
Absolutely gorgeous. I never played Horizon 2. I had Horizon 1. It was fun. I still have not played Forza 6. I don't play racing games too often, and for me to be this excited for one, it's incredible.
I play racing games all the time. This one looks really cool. And the Horizon games are awesome on their own just because,
it's
pretty much a big competition type thing with several different types of racing modes.
Yeah, and it's like
open world.
With
it's
all
set
all
in
friends.
Australia,
yeah, each
which
one
is just a beautiful
different
country.
What I will never go to in real life because it's spiders.
Oh, I'll go.
Oh, I'll stomp on them even though they're probably going to eat your foot in the process.
So,
but another thing I want to throw in about there, and I'm not sure if you're going to switch topics or not, but the fact that you can just jump into someone's, their world, and it changes yours to it, just awesome. Because I know I think Destiny was trying to do that in a sense, and a few other games are trying to do something like that. But they look like they did it flawlessly.
Yes.
Are you about to die?
No, I'm good. speaking of, I don't know what speaking. We Happy Few. Any game coming to the Xbox One and PC. I don't know if it's coming to other things, but it seems very story-based.
Yes, I want it. I want to play it now.
First person, and it looks creepy as hell.
Creepy.
It's set in this weird world where everyone's wearing these like porcelain masks.
And they're high on a drug called Joy.
Yeah, they must take their Joy every day. And when they find out that you haven't, they call you a downer, I think. Yeah. And they start chasing you and try to arrest you.
But when you're not on Joy, you get to see the world for how it actually is.
Like, they're sitting there beating a pinata, and you beat it, and your Joy goes away, and it's a rat, and they're eating its intestines.
Yes. He walks through his office not on Joy, and he realizes they're actually very much behind on their work. The world isn't actually what it is. Which, you know, all the hipsters out there are going to say, well, that's how the world really is. You know, blah, blah, blah. The hipsters.
Why don't you go, you know...
Sorry, I just had to make fun of hipsters sometime during this thing.
Yes.
The other one, this is just a quick little thing, because I'm hyped for it, and they just have showed a few seconds. Hand of Fate 2. It was in the Xbox One indie stuff they were cycling through. And I guess the first one, we've done a couple videos with.
We've only done, like, well, we have another one going up soon.
We have another one going up soon.
But we've only done two videos, but it's a very fun, it's a different game.
Have you ever played it, Mike?
No, I haven't.
It's a card game, right?
Okay.
And you have a bunch of cards in your decks, and then he lays out cards that you walk across. You have to spend food every time you move.
Okay.
And then when you draw the card, it can be like an encounter where you have to give it gold or something. It can be a fight where it'll transform you into like this 3D world where you have to actually play like a fighting game kind of thing. We'll show you some later. It's pretty fun.
Okay. Yeah,
but they're doing a second one.
Yes.
We need to beat the first.
I know the second one, there was one shot they showed of it for sure. Oh, what? Why does the loot box only give you one thing now?
Oh, no, they're all in one circle?
No, there's two things.
Select an unlocked preview. Why is D.Va in the back?
I'm so confused.
Let me see it.
Did it break? I think we broke it. We broke the game.
It was Joe, so we were talking about a bunch of other games.
Yeah. They're all in the center there. We broke the loot box.
When it popped open, only two things popped up, and I was like, why is there only two? Well, we broke it! So wait, what was the...
I think you got an emote for D.Va.
This is a spray. I'm not really that interested. Cool.
Yeah, it's Symmetra, so who gives a fuck?
Emote?
Victory pose?
There's victory pose.
Yeah, it was I Heart You.
Okay. Anyways, back to the what we were talking about. What were we talking about?
Games.
Dishonored 2!
Dishonored 2. I didn't watch too much of that. I'm not gonna lie.
Neither.
I missed that.
I liked the first one.
I understand the merits. A lot of people enjoy it. I tried to play it. I didn't enjoy it too much. But this one looks cool.
Yeah, the one thing on that from the video we saw not too long ago, it looked nice. It was
visually good.
Visually nice.
Definitely.
And the Dishonored games have an interesting art style to it. And it really lended itself to this higher fidelity graphics. As well as they showed this one mission in the full thing where you were in a mansion. And you had this weird device, and you had to keep going back to the past where it was all nice and there were guards.
They didn't talk about
and
how
you shoot back to the current time when it was all like destroyed and everything. You had to keep switching between the two. It was a really cool thing to see.
Yeah, was probably one of the bigger games for that conference. Bethesda ended on it.
Halo Wars 2.
It's Halo Wars.
Yeah.
I tried the beta. It's Halo Wars.
A lot of people are hyped for the campaign, though. That's what makes
it looks
this
pretty
big.
Good.
This is actually a continuation of the first campaigns. So that's what everyone wanted. So they listened and made this.
And the CG trailer was pretty cool.
Yes, the CG trailer was nice.
And that's the main enemy, is that brute.
Yeah, the brute.
The war chief.
Is the, commander of... The enemy, main enemy, which is, they're called the, what are they called? The Banished, or something weird like that, is what they are.
Battlefield 1!
Gorgeous!
I want it!
Just in general. I want it. I'm going to get it. So
finally, somebody has gone to something that's not a futuristic war game.
That's what we all want.
The game looks gorgeous, and I wish EA would have spent a little more time on it during their press conference, besides just CG trailers with tiny bits of gameplay.
Because
after it, they did a huge stream of the multiplayer.
Yeah.
Why didn't they just show, like, a little bit of the multiplayer, even a tiny bit of story in the conference?
Yes, that's what I'm...
Because their conference was really bad this year. EA was stepping over themselves.
They're probably trying to get more money. Somehow.
Yeah, well, that's the wrong way to do it. But... The game itself is gorgeous.
Yes.
I really want to give it a shot.
I mean, I will definitely be disappointed because it's most likely going to be released broken because that's how EA works. They release the game broken and then about 3 months later it's fixed.
They did mention that they're going to try, you know, their best not to make it like the release of Battlefield 4.
That was bad.
It's just visually stunning, though. It takes, like, a Battlefront, how the graphics were just amazing, and then throw those into World War One, and just,
it definitely looks beautiful. Incredible.
Beautiful.
I think that's going to be fun. And finally, like I said, somebody listened, and we're not doing a futuristic war game again.
South Park, Fractured Butthole.
Yes. First of all, Stick of Truth was fun.
Yes.
I didn't play it all, but it was just surprisingly a good game.
You haven't played it? Oh, wow.
I own it. I haven't played it yet.
I own it. It's fun. Really
yeah,
fun.
I know it's fun. I watched, like, a playthrough of it, though. I mean, if that
And
helped.
If you pre-order South Park Fractured Butthole, you get a free copy of Stick of Truth.
Oh, look what's getting pre-ordered next week. Next paycheck.
That gets released in December. Nice. And they changed the combat around. It's not just... It's still turn-based, but you... have the freedom to move a little bit in the environment. You can knock people into your teammates for an extra hit or into objects to take more damage. And then the character customization. One thing I want to mention, it's a direct sequel of Stick of Truth.
Nice.
Slight spoilers here. At the end of Stick of Truth, you become the king. And at the beginning of Fractured But Whole, everyone decided to stop playing medieval and start playing superheroes. And then you walk back in, and right back at it again, Cartman's like, what the hell are you doing here, douchebag? What's with the crown? This is for superheroes. And you have to go in there, and he tells you to sit down, and you try to get in a few different chairs. He's like, not that one, dumbass, until you get the right chair. And then you go in the character creation, which was really cool they showed as well.
Cool. I wonder... no, never mind. I don't know. I don't know. I lost my thought.
I was talking too much about it.
Good game. I'm looking forward to it, though.
Surprise! My feelings on this next game was Titanfall 2.
First one was a flop. This one, potentially good. They have more mechs.
They showed the multiplayer trailer, which was...
Yeah, multiplayer.
There, it was Titanfall. And then they showed the story trailer, which really made me interested to see what was going to happen. Since there's a full campaign in this one.
That's a good idea.
Nonsense that was in the last one.
Yeah, multiplayer campaign.
But that story trailer made me want to play the game again. I watch it, I'm like, I'm probably going to get this game.
Yes.
We'll have to look more into it.
Have you seen the story trailer?
I have not, because I was pretty much not happy with Titanfall, so I didn't even try to attempt to look at Titanfall 2.
I would just watch it E3 conferences as it came on.
It looks
so nice. I watched it. Yeah.
It looks good. More mechs, I think.
Yeah.
Mechs got different abilities.
I think they said they added like 6 more mechs and kept the originals too.
Wow, that's
all
a lot
with
of mechs.
All with the original abilities.
That's a lot. You as a pilot, I think you have technically more abilities is what I'm going to call them. You have this weird like grappling hook. Thing
more abilities, more weapons.
And grapple hook to people.
Yeah,
I died.
No, I was just saying it was funny because I just said grapple hook.
Yeah.
Get over it. Something we saw a tiny bit of, Mass Effect Andromeda.
I'm happy for it. I love Mass Effect.
The tiny bit they showed looked really good. The environments looked really flushed out and gorgeous, to say the least.
Yes.
And I want to see what's more going to happen. And the way it ended was just like, fuck yeah. I'm getting this game whenever it comes out. I am still We're still going through Mass Effect. On
the channel. Yeah, we are going to do a playthrough of all of them.
It's going to take a while. We're still on one.
We hopefully will get this done before
Andromeda
comes out.
Which doesn't even have a release date.
So, I think we will.
Yeah, probably.
Fate. A weird little indie game that EA showed that called back to a lot of platformers and such. And just an interesting little game I wanted to mention. I don't have too much to say on that.
Why did I heal?
One not shown during any of the press conferences, but still mentioned at E3, was Yoku and Laylee.
Oh, yes. I think they showed a little bit of gameplay.
Yeah, they showed a tiny bit in the Microsoft one during the indie thing. And then they released a whole other trailer as well, which took a little shot at Nuts and Bolts.
I thought they showed gameplay, did they?
Yeah.
I thought so.
And the environments look so much better since they originally showed the gameplay.
Now, this is like a super hyped game. A lot of people want this game.
I'm pumped. It looks like the classic Banjo-Kazooie game, man.
Well, I've been living on a rock because I have no clue what you guys are talking about.
It's a
crowdfunded
game, I think, isn't it?
From some of the original developers of Rare, who made Banjo-Kazooie, Banjo-Tooie.
Basically, it's a reimagination, kind of that, with a lizard and something.
It's like a bat creature thing.
Okay.
But it looks like a really fun game. Like, it looks like a classic platformer. Which is really nice. Cool.
Which a lot of people like.
Yeah.
And, never mind, I won't even say it's because it's on the list, I think.
It probably is. Anyways, ReCore. We saw a CG trailer this last year, and we finally got to see some gameplay of it. And it looked very open.
I mean, they're trying to make a new adventure game, is what I'm going to call it. Because that's what it is. For, an Xbox-exclusive adventure game, which... I mean, PC, or not PC, PlayStation.
It's got Uncharted.
Yeah, kind of got every exclusive adventure game you could think of, probably.
Thank you.
And it's not like the game looks bad.
It just
doesn't look...
The gameplay itself just isn't as eye-catching as you would think.
The concept itself may make me play the game and see what happens. And I want to see some more on it to see if there's anything else that intrigues me more. But as of right now, I'm not that excited for it. It's there. What about Final Fantasy 15?
Mike's not a huge Final Fantasy person. Looks amazing, though.
I am going to get this game. This looks really good. Have you tried the Platinum demo?
No.
Give that a shot. You may change your mind.
Okay.
Like, I haven't played a lot of the Final Fantasy. Until recently, it was just 1 and 2. And then I got 13 and 10 that I've been playing for a little bit. And they're alright, but this one changes it completely. It's no longer just a turn-based game. It's got, like, fully interactive combat. The story looks kind of interesting. I'm pumped for this game.
Yes, it looks...
That actually does sound kind of cool, so I definitely give that a shot.
It looks nice.
And then during the...
Now, me also, I haven't been a big Final Fantasy person. I'll play it. Not really a game that I'm going to go out and buy, but this one has changed that. I mean, I would go out and buy this game.
And then during Sony's conference, they showed the VR side mission for this.
I mean, what?
Which I don't know what to say about.
I mean...
It looks like a shitty arcade shooter.
They should...
No.
In the world of
Final Fantasy 15. Not do... VR
I think Sony's like, try to make part of this VR, and we'll give you some money, and then like, here you go, here's some shit.
Now, is this exclusively for the PlayStation VR?
I think so.
I'm about to get great.
I'm getting the game on Xbox One anyways. Any of y'all play The Witcher 3?
Yes,
I have not yet.
Fuck! You!
Mike's been living under a rock, man.
Gwent now has a standalone game coming out.
I mean, I never got into Gwent. Not gonna lie, I'm not sure how the hell to play
I played
that.
A little bit of it. It's not too bad. It's got a decent amount of strategy to it. And the Gwent standalone game is gonna have its own kind of campaign to it. You can choose like one of the four. You can be a Nilfgaard, Scoia'tael monsters, and then something else I can't remember right now.
Yeah, I don't know. But get to build your decks. I think.
Oh
somebody's choking to death on a monster, and I mean the drink.
I'm sorry.
Why did I?
Time to try some more. Yep, get that monster down with some more monster.
I think that's a sign to stop talking about Gwent.
Yeah, Gwent sucks.
Speaking of card games, Elder Scrolls Legends! Hearthstone, but with two sides of the field.
Huh.
Meaning that is the field split in half hot dog style.
Hot dog style.
And enemies in each side can only attack ones in that corridor kind of thing.
Okay.
And if that side's empty, you can also attack your hero, your enemy hero.
Okay.
But you can't attack enemies on the right side if yours is in the left. So you can have like three or something on each side. So it's an interesting mechanic to add, but other than that, it's Hearthstone. Legit Hearthstone.
I mean,
Elder Scrolls.
With how popular Hearthstone is slash was, because I don't know if it's as popular as it was when it like first came out.
Still pretty big.
Everyone's trying to do that now.
Fable.
Fable, which I don't think that's actually going to happen. I think their Kickstarter thing is almost over.
Yeah,
and last time I checked, they went to a different company, don't know what it's called, and Microsoft gave them permission to release that Fable Fortune.
Yeah.
Which is a card game that they were going to announce this year, but they got closed, clearly. Basically, like Hearthstone, the one aspect of it that I thought was cool is it has a co-op mode.
Yeah.
Which I'm not even sure if the game's being made or what.
It's Fable. Who cares?
Well, Fable was a good game.
It was.
It had potential, which they ruined with 3.
Yeah.
Back to E3.
Yes.
Since Vance is not here, I don't think anyone's going to care about this next one.
What is it?
Tekken 7.
Tekken 7. It's a fighting game.
Yeah.
I mean,
don't care.
The
I heard that one evil guy's from Street Fighter, though.
Yeah, he is. He is from Street Fighter. That's why I thought it was like a Street Fighter Tekken.
I think they were supposed
together.
To do that, but they haven't still.
One thing that interests me, I want to say, is when they showed it on the conference, whoever's conference it was, I can't remember who it was.
Mine.
They showed,
I think it was Microsoft's.
No, I don't think it was Microsoft's.
You sure? I think it was Microsoft.
It could have been mine. Who cares? Anyways, they showed this cool CG, like, video, in a sense. And then it opens up into an actual fight. And that's how the campaign is going to be, which I think is pretty cool.
Yeah, it flowed pretty well. And at the end of it, they're like, hey, you have an Xbox One, go download Tekken Tag Tournament for free.
Tag Tournament free. Everyone likes free shit.
The Limbo developers did the same with Limbo. They're like, here you go, free game.
Free!
Xbox, Dead Rising 4.
That looks kind of cool.
It looks good.
Frank West.
Christmas!
Yes, Frank West from the original.
They should have never got rid of him. And
no.
I was kind of disappointed with Dead Rising 3.
Oh, hold on. Let me stop you there. Dead Rising 2 was a disappointment.
Dead Rising 2 was a good game. Dead Rising 3...
3 I enjoyed.
...was...
No, 3 was
...less
good.
Than mediocre.
I disagree. Dead Rising 3 is pretty awesome.
Dead Rising 3 was good. Dead Rising 2, I didn't like how I was on a time limit to find some more Zombrex for that.
That's the only thing that sucked about that game.
Which she came back and...
Can we all agree...
Spoiler, by the way.
...that Dead Rising 1 was the best anyways?
Dead Rising
1.
In that mall. We're going back to a mall. And the outskirts of the mall this time, too.
And, you know, I was wondering if it was that mall.
Yeah.
It looks like it.
It looks like it.
I know they definitely said you can go outside the mall as well.
Yeah, it looked like they... Because you can get vehicles and stuff.
Yeah, you can go outside the mall. But it's based in the mall, which is... I think it's the same mall.
That would be awesome.
Anyway,
that mall was
looks great.
Cool. Wow, that was
did that have a release date? Yeah, this holiday season.
Yeah.
I think it was
December.
So, look for that. Xbox One and PC first, but I think it's coming to PlayStation later.
What?
Is?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a Microsoft exclusive.
Time
yeah.
exclusive.
It's never gone to PlayStation.
No, Dead Rising 2 was on PlayStation.
Dead Rising 2
was on PlayStation?
Yeah.
I thought it was an exclusive, because it's part of the Play Anywhere thing, I thought.
It's a time exclusive coming to PS4 and Steam.
Really?
Huh.
I did not know that till now.
Well, yeah, Dead Rising 3 did come to
it
PC.
Is part of the Play Anywhere thing, though, so if you're buying an Xbox One, you get it on PC for free.
Oh, well, then that destroys our theory of Play Anywhere things were only Xbox exclusives.
Yeah, but I wonder if it's... I don't know.
That's weird. Okay, anyways.
Sea of Thieves!
That looks awesome.
That's a fun game if you have friends.
The way they announced it was pretty cringy with the fake like YouTuber commentary. But the game itself was...
Wait, no, I like that.
I don't.
The trailer they had where it was just random like stills of pirates dying.
Yeah, that didn't show much.
That was stupid. No one really liked it. But the actual gameplay of actual players, they brought people to their studio and recorded them playing the game.
Rare is actually making a good game again. After, like, giving up on games since 08 and making, like, Kinect shit, it's nice to see them making a game that looks fun.
Yeah. Yes.
This looks like it'll be really cool. Yeah, especially with a good group of friends.
Yeah.
Y'all just raid the seas together. I want to see what all you can do.
Yeah,
because it looks interesting.
You can drink and get drunk. I know that. Yes. They show that.
Yes. Walking around and almost falling. It's pretty cool.
Another CG trailer with not much information. State of Decay 2.
I haven't seen anything happening about it, but I want it.
State of Decay was a really fun game with some neat concepts. And yes. I'll play a second one. That's all I have to say about that.
Definitely.
Did they ever make State of Decay 1 multiplayer?
I don't think so.
No.
This one is, because the trailer shows multiple people.
I'm pretty sure it is. I think I heard
something
about
that. That would be really awesome if they make this one multiplayer. That was one thing I wish that they did with the original one. Made a multiplayer.
That would have made it so much better.
Yes.
Even though it was a good game.
Yeah.
Disappointment, at least in my opinion, Ghost Recon Wildlands. I saw the CG trailer for this. Was it last year at E3, or was it after that?
I think it was after that. I'm not...
Well, I remember seeing a CG trailer for it, but... And then we saw a large amount of gameplay for it this year at E3. And it looks really disappointing. It looks really dull.
It kind of looks like The Division, but not weird, snowy, wasteland in New York.
And what gamers will literally say to each other, 2 tangos down. People don't talk like that.
No.
Or 2 tangos ahead. Like, no, they're like, oh shit, there's a couple of guys up there.
Fuck enemies! Run! Shoot! That's what we say.
Yeah, pretty much.
Except that one guy who goes on to, like, Battlefield and all those games and
tries to be serious.
Military AI. Yeah, which is very popular videos if you see them. They're pretty funny, actually.
Well, at least in my opinion, it might be fun with friends.
Possibly, yes.
Going to take down targets.
If you want to see some gameplay where they kind of just goof off, but it shows kind of the gameplay of it. I know some other YouTubers were asked to play it. I know Dahi DeNovo is one of them, that Irish bastard.
Cool.
What's wrong with Irish?
Nothing wrong with Irish.
No, nothing's wrong with him. He's just funny, if you ask me.
I just don't like that group of people.
But... Him, I know Louis Caliber.
Not Irish people.
A lot of
good.
He does. I mean, I don't know if he has a video up of it, but I know he played it. You can check them out and see if you like it or not.
And the backstory itself is kind of neat. Like, it's a country that, I don't remember what country, but it's a country that has a lot of certain
llamas. Has a lot of llamas.
And that plant can technically be used to make cocaine. So the cartel moves in there and starts using that plant to make cocaine. Because they use it for, like, medicines and stuff there. So the cartel takes over, and you're part of the team to stop that.
There's always something about the cartel.
Hey, Eagle Flight. No. Opinions?
I didn't even watch it.
It looks boring.
This is all you, buddy.
It's a VR game. It's Eagle Capture the Flag.
With
multiplayer.
Eagle guns, you say.
Yeah, and you can shoot people with your Eagle guns.
It's VR. I see what they're trying to go for. Something that, you know, you gotta be quick with because you're flying really fast.
It seems really just gimmicky.
It feels like something that they were like, hey, we need a cool VR game that is multiplayer. Do this. And they did that.
Now I want to talk about a VR game that actually looks really cool. Star Trek Bridge Crew. You work together with people. So I feel like this is... The best case scenario is if you somehow get 4 people in with your VR headsets in the same space, but you work together with a group of friends to pretty much drive, control, fly, and interact, or take battles in the Star Trek universe against other ships.
Mm-hmm. Which so is really cool. So we see a Star Destroyer?
No, that's Star Wars. We're talking about good sci-fi.
No,
here.
We're not. No, Star Wars is definitely better than Star Trek. Go sit the fuck down.
Anyway.
I'll have to agree. You must pop a squat, bro.
We're all sitting.
Good point.
Okay, stand
up.
I'm excited for it, and I like how they showed it with some previous cast member from Star Trek series.
Yes.
They seemed really excited to even play it. And then Crash Bandicoot.
Yes.
This is what I was avoiding from talking about a few times before.
Being remastered, Crash 1, 2, and something, the third one.
I don't care about
the name
called.
Of it.
It's a W. I've never been too big into...
No!
Yeah, I've never been...
Warped.
Yeah, Warped. I've never been too big a fan of Crash. I always preferred some other platforms.
I enjoyed the first Crash.
I had two,
Crash
I think
Bandicoot
it was.
Awesome.
And it was fun. I'm probably going to get the remasters because I like platforms.
Crash Bandicoot.
And then they showed how they're bringing him back in the new Skylanders.
Yes.
No,
it was kind of a disappointment.
I think the game, the remastering is them itself, but they are adding Crash Bandicoot as a playable character in this new Skylanders game. I don't think the remasters are through the Skylanders game.
No, they're not.
No.
That's
not
what I'm
saying. The way you just put that made it sound like the remasters are...
Oh, no. They're remastering the games you can buy those eventually.
Yes.
And then on the side, they're bringing them into Skylanders. Which
is...
I don't understand it.
They're trying to keep a dead thing alive.
They just need to stop Skylanders and go back to some good Spyro games.
Oh my god, I would love a good new Spyro remaster. Or,
remaster
or just a new standalone game like they did with Ratchet and Clank. Just reboot it.
I feel like I'm in the minority here because I was looking some stuff up because I really wanted to play this Spyro game I used to have.
Yeah.
And across the internet it was smeared for being the worst Spyro game ever. But I really loved it.
Tales of the Dragon?
Yeah, it was Under the Dragonfly. I had that one and I really liked it. And then I started looking it up, trying to find it again.
That's the one I'm thinking.
And everyone was fucking hating on it. I'm like, oh, I guess I liked the wrong one. Something's wrong with my brain.
I think there was one called Tales of the Dragon, or something like that, where all the dragons get turned to stone.
Yes.
And then you have to go, defeat the bad guy that did it or something. That was the good one.
That one was awesome.
I fucking love that bitch.
Any y'all like Grow Home?
Grow Home is fun. We did an episode of it, and I think we're going to do more eventually.
Yeah, maybe go some more Dodo Elimination Squad.
We are very weird with our videos. We're just all over the place. We should probably make a series and stick to it and do it regularly. Do it regularly. Vance isn't too regular with games. Anyways, good game. Grow Home, good.
Is now getting a sequel called Grow Up.
Grow Up.
Which looks like a little... bit of the same stuff and some more abilities.
Yes.
It looks like it'll be a fun little experience. Grow Home was a really unique
Which
game.
Is weird that I would see something like that show up at E3
it
and
was
be
really
an
popular.
Actual decent announcement. I don't know. It's weird for me to see that.
Well, what about Trials of the Blood Dragon?
Trials is fun. I'm not too
Blood
sure
Dragon
what
was fun.
Blood Dragon was.
Far Cry 3 Blood Dragon.
I didn't play it.
You fuckhead.
I didn't have Far Cry 3.
You didn't need it.
Well, I didn't buy it separately.
Bro, that was a fun game.
It was
really
cool.
Weird, but fun.
Definitely
and
weird.
It fits the Trials universe, I guess. It's weird enough. Yeah. And it was out right now. What are you doing?
I was doing horrible, so I'm finding a new lobby.
You're on my account, man.
Oh,
you're going to get
fuck.
An XP deduction eventually. You keep leaving.
I left one game!
Yeah, I know. Well, it's out now. Watch Dogs 2.
Fuck your XP anyways. What did you just do?
Nothing. Watch Dogs 2.
I'm looking forward to it.
I'm not.
I think it'll be pretty cool.
First one was kind of a flop.
I disagree.
And I think this one's going to be pretty similar.
They showed a lot when they originally announced Watch Dogs, and then they took a lot out from the release.
Maybe I almost said Watch Dogs.
I did.
Watch Dogs. The thing that I do like with Watch Dogs 2 is they actually really do make it to where you can hack everything.
And the protagonist is not Blandy McBlandface,
also
known as Aiden.
It's a new person?
Yeah, it's
a
new protagonist who actually has charisma and doesn't, look and sound like a pile of brown pudding.
You mean shit?
Yeah, I was about to say, by brown pudding, he means shit.
Yeah.
Because brown pudding would have more charisma than I think.
Unless it comes out of your ass.
Then that's called shit.
Exactly. Shit. You're a shithead.
Which was Watch Dogs 1.
I enjoy
Watch
Dogs 1.
Where does this new one take place at?
San Francisco?
Yeah.
It looked like a nice place where it took place.
And I liked the one-seated smart car that they showed.
Oh, I didn't even see that.
It was like a really skinny-ass thing.
I mean, shoot, it might actually come to be.
All right, what about Zelda Breath of the Wild?
That looks pretty
beautiful.
Cool.
First of all, Nintendo, what the fuck were you doing this year?
I don't know if they
You're not going to do a press conference. We're just going to sit and play games for 2 8-hour conferences.
Sounds fun.
Anyways.
I'd do it.
The first one had like 7 hours of Zelda, which I didn't watch the whole thing because holy crap. Anyways, it was a really beautiful environment.
Yes.
The art style.
It's free roam.
But there's still no release date.
No release. Well, it's supposed to be a release title for the NX, I thought. Which I'm surprised they didn't release anything about the NX at this E3.
Yeah, they did mention beforehand nothing will be there related to the NX.
That's upsetting,
though. It is, because, I mean, they spent, like, what did you just say? 2 8-hour sessions of playing video games straight that they could have at
they
least mentioned
something.
They could have
thrown 5 minutes of the NX and everyone would have went wild. Your stock would have went up, motherfuckers.
Nintendo doesn't know how to be a company.
Well, also, Nintendo releases stuff throughout the year. They don't just wait for E3 like most other games.
Well, because they don't have third-party developers making games with them, really.
Yeah.
This reminded me of something. Tangent. What's their face? Platinum Games?
Yes.
Said they're working on 3 separate games right now. Scalebound. Which they will be doing more of in the future, they said. If it goes... They're planning to do more than just this game on Scalebound. They enjoy it. Bayonetta 3.
Eh.
Bayonetta 2.
I mean, I'm
game.
Not saying they weren't good, me personally.
And one guy, I don't remember who it was, I was reading this earlier. They were intrigued about making an Okami 2. Which is a game from a while ago.
Yeah, that's older.
So I want to see what they're going to be doing next few years. Like, I'm enjoying their games. When they make a game, I'll probably buy it. Especially if it's a new Bayonetta. What about Pokemon Sun and Moon?
Who doesn't like Pokemon?
This one actually changed a lot.
Yes, it did. A lot of people actually aren't too fond when they did the, when they were showing it. They said this is, like, really kid-oriented. Like, younger people. But they did say they were trying to make this enjoyable by old fans, new fans, and all fans.
And I think it really needed something new, because how many times can we do the same thing,
now,
the same story, pretty much?
This is weird. They take place on an island.
4 islands.
Yeah, islands. Whatever. Same difference. One thing I saw, they showed a little bit of the campaign. Story. Whatever. That's mostly what it is. And I'm going to talk about the new game mode they introduced. But normally when you start out, you have a rival, blah, blah, blah. And when you pick a water type, they're going to pick the grass type. You know, all that good stuff.
Yeah.
This didn't. He picked the water type, and they picked the fire type.
Maybe it's just randomized.
Is it randomized? That's the question. Why would they pick a... Or that's making me think they do get a second... like a tribute type, not a tribute, future on that maybe it'll affect it a little more.
And come on, the water type off on this new one anyway.
Actually, looked pretty good. It's doing.
Oh, not as a Pokemon, just visually. I don't.
Oh
like
yeah,
I can have that playing near me.
Wasn't. No.
What about Quake? Ain't got. Either of you played the older Quake games?
Yes.
No, I don't think I have.
So you have. See the CG trailer for the new one?
Yeah, I showed him.
Opinions.
He probably wasn't paying attention, though.
I probably was not.
As I saw him on his phone. But
it's interesting. I like that they're building a new Quake game, but what concerned me is that the developer there said Well, mostly he started out with a not technical jargon, like, oh, it'll run, it unlock frames per second, and gave a bunch of specs and such. And then he just mentioned that there'll be different classes, which will have predetermined loadouts.
Now, what's so wrong with that?
Nothing, but it's changed a lot, and I think they're just hopping onto the Overwatch wagon with that.
Yeah, probably.
That's all I really have to say. Skyrim Remaster.
I have a PC, so I modded the shit out of it to make it look really cool.
And PC users with all the DLC are going to get it for free, so you'll get it for free, and all previous mods will work on it still. I got it on console, which means I'll have to buy the game, and I probably will, because I want to mod it, and I'll play through it on the new graphics, which will look a lot better, in my opinion. Clint seems to share a different opinion.
I do. First off,
your opinion doesn't matter.
People are going to hate the shit out of what I'm about to say right now. But, no offense to whoever likes this game.
Offense taken.
Skyrim, Fallout. I'm sorry, but you guys are kind of just, for casual gamers, those RPGs. Casual. Anyone can pick that up and play it.
Yeah.
This 5-year-old can do that if they want it. Okay.
It's not going to keep me from enjoying it.
Now, did it have a good story? Yes. I mean, I played it. I beat it. I played DLC. But you're going to re-release it on next-gen consoles. Cool beans, whatever. But am I going to have to pay a full $60 again for this just because it's got better graphics and I can add mods to it?
Yeah.
Why?
That's kind of stupid.
Why?
If you were to remaster game,
why?
One I would prefer would have been Oblivion.
Yes.
Because Oblivion I loved so much more than Skyrim.
Do something that
that's much older than Skyrim.
Well, see,
as well.
No. The reason probably why they're doing Skyrim is Skyrim's probably
because it's
got
casual
more...
Fast 2011.
Yeah. And you go on and you talk to any person who's played a video game ever, they're going to know what Skyrim is. Everyone. People still play that.
And
like it's their fucking the only game out there, which upsets me so much. Because there are so many other games that I would play over Skyrim any day of the week.
You play Widowmaker so much.
I love Widowmaker, man. She's bae. She's bae. Yeah, I said it. She's bae. Oh, this isn't the...
No comment.
As a publisher, and they already mentioned before that to make sure that Fallout 4 board with the same engine name just booted up Skyrim and then next Gen console pretty much, you know, flipped it over to see if it would work. So they knew it was already on Xbox One for Bethesda themselves. As a publisher, what would you remaster to make a shit ton of money? Skyrim.
Yes. I'm not saying, you know, they're wrong to make a shit ton of money for, you know, remastering it. I just kind of wish
they would have went a different direction.
Done a different game or added more stuff that you don't get on the original that would actually be worth me paying another $60, which I bought the DLC too for the first one, so that's what, how much was the DLC each about?
Not too much actually.
I mean, I paid an extra.
The house one was $5, I think.
I paid an extra on top of the $60 I already spent on the game. Now you're bringing out for next-gen consoles, which I still have my 360, so I can go play it anytime I want.
It did run like shit on previous-gen consoles.
But you're going to re-release it. Is it going to have the DLC?
Yeah.
Did they say that? Okay, nice. But for another $60, man, I already own it. Why make me pay another $60 for it?
You don't have to, though.
See, now the one would really make
it
worth it.
I just feel like it should be cheaper.
One thing that would be really worth it for, like, the console people, since they have to pay for it, is if they added extra missions or something like
that. That's what I'm saying. If they add extra content.
They have mods. Have you seen some of the user-generated mods out there?
Yes,
there are some
awesome ones. But have you seen what they're going to say, okay, we'll allow this mod? No, we don't know what they're going to allow. They could allow the most garbage mods there are out there.
I've been playing a lot of Fallout 4, which now has mods, and there's a lot of really good stuff they put in there. The main ones that they're taking out are just because of copyright reasons or too adult.
Oh, so you can't run around with a giant dragon and beat up a...
No.
But I did get Genji's sword and Reinhardt's hammer, so I'm fucking good. What about LEGO Star Wars 7?
It's a LEGO. game. It's going to do good. Everyone enjoys the Lego games, even adults.
And it had a lot of humor.
It's got the nice humor that everyone's going to laugh at.
And Lego Star Wars, it was always fun.
Yes,
I played through them all.
Got them all.
I got the demo. I still got to try it out the Lego Star Wars 7. But that comes out in like a week or something, doesn't it?
I think so.
Yep, very soon.
Prey.
By the time this
I really want to talk about Prey.
They didn't show much, I don't think, did they?
They showed a CG trailer. But a couple years ago at E3, they had a Prey 2 from another developer, but it got canceled. And it looked like a really good game. And apparently this has nothing to do with that canceled game.
Yeah, this
game,
is supposed to be... Yes, a lot of people wanted Prey 2. This is supposed to be just like a reboot, I think. They're rebooting the series itself, from what I understand.
The game looks good, but...
We don't know if the game looks good. The trailer...
The CG trailer looks good.
But does the game actually look good? That's
the
question.
I guess we have to wait till probably next year to see anything else.
Probably.
Again, another one I think Vance would be the only one here interested in. So I'm just going to... Last Guardian?
It's finally got a release date for everyone that's actually interested in it.
I like Shadow of the Colossus.
A lot of people think that the Shadow of the Colossus has... This has to do with that, but it doesn't. This is its own game. They are not in the same universe, from what I understand.
I think it... Isn't this Ico and Shadow of the Colossus all in the same kind of universe, though?
I don't think so. It could
pretty
be.
Sure
I'm
it is. I didn't like Ico. I know people love the fuck out of Ico. I like Shadow of the Colossus. That was really cool. And I don't have much interest in the next story yet.
Shadow of the Colossus was good, but I did hear it has nothing to do with this game. Just going to say. I feel like they should just make a new Shadow of the Colossus. Everyone likes Shadow of the Colossus.
Yeah. Oh! I remember two other games that aren't on the list. Mountain Blade, there was a new one you were talking about.
They just showed some Siege gameplay. I think it was Mountain Blade 2 something. I don't know if that's out already or whatnot. It might just be a new update or DLC you can get.
There was an Attack on Titan game. Wasn't very good in the press conferences, but...
have any interest on Attack on Titan.
I don't watch anime, so I don't know much about the series itself.
I know are these giant things that eat humans and they're naked.
And I saw the gameplay where you were, like, cutting off limbs and fucking them up, and it looked kind of fun, but that's all I really have to say about it. I just wanted to mention it. Detroit Become Human! That looks pretty
Jesus.
Cool.
Not just is it beautiful, but the way it plays, it's all changes depending on what you do.
It looks like a really fun kind of crime game.
Yeah.
Well, who knows? Is it going to be crime? Because the trailer itself, not the gameplay kind of trailer, which it wasn't even a gameplay trailer. I don't know how to
describe it. There was some gameplay
in
there.
Yeah, but it wasn't... I don't know how to describe it.
There was a lot of, detective.
The, CG trailer is what I'm talking about. It just shows this one person, not a person, an android, that's who the main person... thing is in this trailer in particular, deciding that she doesn't want to be like a regular android and be, you know, controlled. She wants to think for herself. She's basically thinks for herself is what I think it was really getting at.
What? I feel like I'm lost here.
You didn't see that trailer?
I saw the gameplay one. That
Not the gameplay
the press
one,
conference.
The actual CG trailer.
Oh, no, I don't
about.
Think I've seen that one.
Well, you should watch it. This girl's voice, she's basically just talking, blah, 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 all that good shit. And then she just basically, all these other androids are turning and, want to follow her, in a sense. I guess that's a good way to put it. She's just, thinking for herself, and, yeah. So I don't know exactly what this game is about. All I know is the gameplay trailer they showed... you were playing as someone completely different who was a negotiator.
Connor.
And there was another android who was tired of... if you actually pay attention to all the little details, he's actually going to be replaced. That's why he's freaking out. But he's finally thinking for himself and deciding that he doesn't want to be controlled by humans anymore. He wants, it's up to him what's going to happen next. Is he going to kill this little girl that he's got hostage, or, you're there to stop that.
And that can end in many different
ways. Yeah, many,
yes,
depending
on
what you do.
You choose.
It's just amazing what they're doing nowadays.
The only thing I kind of worry about with that is how many different changes or outcomes are there going to be? I mean,
that was a demo they had there, and they said there was a ton of outcomes just for that one
right,
scenario.
But the thing I'm trying to go at, though, is hopefully it's not like, how do I explain it? Hopefully it's not like, you know, some of the outcomes are like extremely similar.
Like, yeah, I know what you mean by that.
Yeah. Now, this is what I look for in this game, what I really want to happen, is I want all the scenarios to somehow interact with each other. Like, if they all are bad scenarios and androids start, you know, like killing people or doing bad things that you don't want, is it going to affect, you know, the other scenarios in the future? Is it going to be like, are there going to be more guards that, okay, for example, let's say an android robs a bank. You know, and you fail it, android gets away. Are there going to be more guards at banks, and are people not going to trust androids as much? And is that going to affect future scenarios?
Yeah, like, will your decisions have long-term impact?
Yes, or is this just going to be just a bunch of random scenarios that you know, do?
I kind of hope for the way that you're explaining it, because I don't want to, you know, have to play through it several times in order to get a completely different outcome than just, like, you know, when you have several ways and you actually choose four of the same ways that the girl lives the same way.
Yeah, I understand.
Kind of hard to explain.
Yeah, no, I get what you're saying.
How do you feel about Resident Evil 7?
Confused. The CG trailer that they had there was just, there was nothing
apparently
really to
last
follow.
Year, they had a VR kind of demo called The Kitchen. And that kitchen demo was actually Resident Evil 7. They didn't tell anyone that for this year.
Wow.
And because this is also fully playable in VR or not in VR. And I downloaded the demo. I have not yet to try it. We may just do that for video. We'll see.
Yeah.
Anyways, the game is actually going back to horror instead of action-packed nonsense like
yes.
Resident Evil 6 was.
Yeah, so we need to get Vance to play it so we can see if he pisses himself.
Which I see very popular for VR.
Pissing yourself?
No.
Horror.
Oh,
games.
Okay.
That's one place where I see it'll...
Oh, shit, I just died. looks good. There is a playable demo right now. I don't know if it's the same demo. I know it doesn't involve the actual game and your different protagonists in the actual game. But one thing I noticed that from what I hear about someone I know who played the demo and the trailer is I didn't see any zombies or anything zombie really related except some dead people. It's Resident Evil. There should be zombies if you ask me.
So that makes me wonder if they're actually going to before everything went down.
Yeah.
Before all the zombies.
Okay, what I heard is that in Japan or wherever it is, I don't know exactly who makes this game or whatnot, if it's Japan, China, or whatever, the game is called Resident Evil 7 Biohazard. But from what I hear is in the U.S. version, it's going to be called Resident Evil 7 First Hour, or maybe it's the other way around, where in Japan it's called
Biohazard's
First Hour.
So
maybe it's in Japan, it's called First Hour, and here it's called Biohazard. But the demo has multiple endings from what I hear, just depending on how you play. So that I really look forward to. I think we're going to do a video about that.
Let's talk about some sneaky motherfuckers.
Sneaky motherfuckers.
Call of Duty Infinite War.
Oh, geez. Going back to the Battlefield one that I was talking about, there goes Call of Duty once again.
I did really enjoy watching this press conference for Sony, because after this happened, there was like two claps compared to the God of War one at the beginning, which was just a roar. But they were sneaky with it. And I think they needed to be, because if they opened up with Call of Duty, everyone would just turn off right there. Be like,
yep.
Oh, fuck it, who cares? But they started out, you're on a space station, you get in there, you're like ziplining, you break off this guy's oxygen mask, which seems neat, but and then you get through the window, shuts down, boots on the ground, it's Call of Duty gameplay again. this standard old Call of Duty.
I mean, it's a first-person shooter. Most of them are all exactly the same.
Yes, but hopefully they don't have the stupid dances that they have in the new one.
Oh, when you win,
and you do the stupid.
I mean, a lot of people like that. It's just a little taunt you can
play. But it's really dumb. In my opinion, it's really bad.
Well, I'm not trying to agree on that one, but what do you think about Death Stranding?
There's nothing to think about it except Norman Reedus.
There was a weird ass trailer.
Literally ass.
I think.
Literally, you get to see CG Norman Reedus ass in this trailer.
I think that Sony really wanted Hideo Kojima to come out and say something.
And just, I mean, everyone's hyped for whatever he's about to do.
Because the man is a genius.
He is.
He can make a fucking game.
Yeah, but
what is this about?
Nothing. There's dead
baby
sea creatures. There's a weird baby that disappears. There's baby handprints on a naked Norman's leg. What is going on?
And there's like five floating guys, which may be the weird space thing that
humanoids
was his logo or whatever on possibly. But
no one knows.
It's really
give us more
confusing.
What is it?
What's going on?
Our announcement.
Who hurt you?
This was actually announced before E3. I just wanted to bring it up while we were at it. Agents of Mayhem. I don't know if any of y'all saw
I saw a little bit of gameplay.
It's from Volition. Same people who made Saints Row, and it's in the same universe.
It's in the same universe. It takes place after 4.
Okay. So it's in the same universe.
It takes place where all
But it's
the
a different
world,
kind
though.
Of game. There's like a team of people, you know, all with interesting personalities.
You play as all your whole team. You pick 3 people, and I think they said there's going to be 12 different heroes you can play as. You pick 3 of them to go out on your missions with you. And you get to switch in between those 3. You play as everyone. I'm not sure if there's any co-op mode or split screen or anything like that. But you play as them, and then it's very important that you switch in between the 3. Because they each do different things, you know, better long range, close range, whatever. But you are part of a group that's basically set to. There's a bunch of acronyms for what your groups are called. I don't even know what they're called. But there's bad guys, like normal, and you're basically a band of people set out to stop them. And it takes place all over the world. I know the gameplay I saw took place, I want to say South Korea.
They showed gameplay of it?
I don't know if it was from E3, but I saw gameplay of the game.
Oh.
And they were talking about it.
Well, I'm just going to move on because we're getting a little lengthy.
Yeah.
Spider-Man from Insomniac.
That looks amazing. Cool. I want it.
If anyone can do a good kind of open world third person action game, it's Insomniac.
Yes.
They made the Infamous games. No, the first one was really fun. I haven't played any of the others.
Infamous second son is pretty cool.
I might give it a shot at some point. It's probably cheap at this point.
Yeah, you probably think
Oh, yeah.
The footage they showed looked amazing.
It does.
And I loved, I think it was Spider-Man 3, the game. I'm not sure which one it was. Where you could actually roam on the ground and basically free roam the city and just do random stuff. I hope it's like that.
Well, yeah, one thing I really have been looking forward to is them to make a game that's similar to, like, Batman, where it's open world and you can run around and do stuff. So it's kind of cool that they finally made another superhero movie that's like that. Superhero game.
I think we're going to end on our last topic the way Sony did. Days Gone. Another zombie game! They started the conference with a very story trailer.
Yes.
And they ended it with straight gameplay.
And the gameplay will come off.
Oh, it does.
It's an open world kind of third person action zombie game, but there's waves of zombies and they're like crawling over each other and climbing up shit.
If you've seen the movie World War Z and how the zombies are just crazy like that, that's how they are in this game.
You just see like massive horde of them coming through everywhere.
But pretty much complete free roam, from what I hear. Complete free roam. And the zombies, not only just like a normal zombie game, how they're going to come and attack you and stuff, but they actually think and they try pinning you like into a position where the only way out is through the zombies. And there's so many of them that that's near impossible from what I can tell. It just, it looks good. I'm going to pick it up. Fun.
I'm picking it up too.
And then I'm going to purchase it after I pick it up. Because I can't just
put it in your cart. Walk to the register, give it to the cashier, pay for it, leave the store.
What are you talking about? Just do like what I did when we went to the restaurant.
Almost leave.
Yes.
Or just go to your console's online store, purchase it, download it.
Now, do we know, is that a PlayStation exclusive?
Oh, let me check. Sure, yeah.
We're going to see. One thing though, I think at the end here we should talk about one thing that completely won E3 for us. Because there was so much there.
And one thing that really pissed me off about E3. It's not really E3's fault, obviously.
Oh, and I know what you're going to talk about. Okay, we're still checking for Days Gone.
PlayStation.
PlayStation exclusive. Good thing I have a PlayStation. Alright, so now that's our complete list. You know, there are stuff we missed. We didn't really talk too much about tech. And I mean,
may have gotten a couple things, details a little off, but
yeah,
but that's
going off some memory here.
One thing I am extremely disappointed in, and I was really hoping for, is for Rockstar to have a conference and release.
Has Rockstar ever had their own conference?
I don't know. They may have.
I don't think they
did. GT5.
I don't think they did because they don't have enough games to hold.
Yeah,
an hour
a
conference
isn't
yeah.
just normally one game unless you're Nintendo for some reason.
No, they have more than that. They just showed that game for 7 hours.
Yeah.
But I was really disappointed that there wasn't Red Dead Redemption and Rockstar wasn't there at all. Because it was heavily rumored that they were going to be there to announce Red Dead Redemption 2, which I'm really looking forward to. I'm thinking they're in production of it. They just haven't said anything.
No one's confirmed this. So
he might
be,
so
he might
rumors
be
may be wrong.
For nothing.
I might be.
He might be getting hyped for... What's another Rockstar game that's trash that I can think of? I can't think of one right now.
I don't know.
That's trash?
Yeah, because I was going to say he's getting really hyped for and then say a trash game.
Well,
and
can't even think of any by Rockstar. They're really trash.
Anyway.
Off the top of
now,
head, at least.
Let's definitely say one thing that won E3 for us. Who wants to start?
Fuck.
Fuck? Okay.
I'm trying to. There's
Mike. One thing that won E3 for you. Go.
Horizon Zero Dawn. I cannot wait for that game.
Which is weird because we would have expected Mike, who's a big racing game fan, to say Forza Horizon 3.
Forza Horizon 3 does look awesome.
Or Battlefield because he loves that Battlefield game. I mean games.
Yes. Man. Yeah, just like you love that Gears of War game.
Oh,
I
dude,
mean,
that
game.
Fucking Marcus saw. Oh.
Well, one E3 for me was Overwatch, which wasn't even there. Take more of my money.
Okay, well, that doesn't really count.
Okay.
Well, we'll skip him for now. Oh, one thing that won E3 for me.
I'm going to go with a bit of wild card just because it's so different, and I'm glad to see something that's just not more of the same. And I'm going to give it Steep.
Steve?
I'm tired. Okay. Every single game right now is just shooting and shooting and shooting
yes.
and shooting and shooting.
Yeah.
I'm glad to see
this whole time.
An extreme sports game again, and one that looks so different to the previous extreme sports games. Give me some Steve. Clint?
This
and
is...
nobody cares about your opinion.
How about that Gears dick?
I'm not actually going to say Gears at all. Except old man Marcus was pretty freaking intense.
You gonna pop on Kratos this day?
That's not what I was gonna say either.
Oh, let's hear it.
I mean, Kratos the second. This isn't one thing, but it's one genre.
Watch Dogs?
No, definitely not. I'm not interested at all.
Just Dance?
No.
Just
Dance was garbage.
Pokemon.
I don't like Just Dance. No! God damn it! We didn't even talk about that, actually.
Wait, Zelda the Breath of Life?
Wait, we did talk about that. Which I forgot to mention about Battle Royale. About it. Anyways,
for
just the zombie
Battle
games.
Boyfriend?
Okay, you guys are fucking...
Not your neighbors?
Was that an actual game?
Isn't it?
Car Mechanic Simulator 2014.
Farming Simulator 2017.
They
that
have
is what you were
this
say.
Competition. There's professional farmers in
yes.
the game. You want that fishing game.
That fishing game.
No. The zombie games are coming.
You want Days Gone.
I want Days Gone. I want Dead Rising. I want Resident Evil, even though we can't confirm that that's a zombie game or not. Just zombies. I love zombie games. Anything zombie. And the fact
you know
that
they're all forgotten.
We have a decent amount coming that look good. That's what excites me.
That's what makes you get go hard.
Yeah. And then that's Kratos cool. does. So Kratos is second for me.
I think that's if there's anyone left, thanks for listening to a bunch of E3 talk.
Hopefully it's
already done. Probably what, like an hour or so.
We'll catch you next time.
Bye.
Bye.